Hey, look at that beautiful tree. Way to start off the episode. Hey, everybody. Welcome. Welcome to episode 39. That is a big tree. That is actually much better than I anticipated. Today, I'm drawing a little bit of inspiration. Just watched an episode from B-Dubs, and he did some outside work with trees and stuff, and it got me to thinking about how... Ooh, leg spike? Hello? Okay, not sure what that was about. Let's talk about, trees and grass and stuff. He wasn't actually building, and I was kind of wanting to do something like that today, and I just decided that I'm going to go all out on that kind of stuff today and really work on the outside in this area because there's a difference. There's a big difference between just walking through buildings and walking through an immersed area with plants and whatnot. See, look, this is like the extreme example. Just walking by this house, nothing. It's not doing anything for me. Over here, we've done a bit of this stuff already. Walking through here, I get it. Although, could use more grass. Walking through here, get a little bit more grass. Hitboxes are so hard to find. Hello? Right there? It just gives a little... I don't want that big thing right there. I don't want it right in the pathways where we're walking. But I was looking over here. And I was thinking, well, this is such an ugly area. And we talked about how we weren't going to build anything here. As far as buildings. Because I wanted this shack over there to be off in the distance. All on its own. Separated. That's kind of like, that's what makes it interesting. It's all the way over there, all on its own. So I do want something over here. I decided that we might as well go ahead and give it a bit of a, I don't need all that. I'm just going to pick it up again, but work on this area as far as the immersion stuff goes. This little pond here can probably be all covered up, so I think I'm going to do that. I replaced that little pond with dirt, and it reminded me that I also tore down, there was a big piece of beach right there, and I thought if I open it up, it would really open up the sea here, and it did. The only problem, and maybe you could tell, is the water is a different color because it's a beach biome there. It's this color instead of that color, which isn't horrible here, but there it's pretty noticeable. It looks kind of weird. I'm not too worried about it, though. I'd rather have it be open because that is much better. I'm feeling much more immersed. Maybe you noticed I'm not running shaders right now. Just don't feel like it. Sometimes it's just nice to play with the render distance up and FPS that are enjoyable. I mean, I get over 30 otherwise, but it's noticeable, especially once you go back to being at much higher. Let's put another tree right here. And that is a really ugly tree. I'm going to have to take that down. Finally, a good tree. I tried right here quite a few times. I got some of the ugliest trees that you've ever seen. Their mama didn't even want them. But we got three pretty decent trees here. That one's cool. See, that's how I want these. Really, really horizontally or laterally expanding. Now, this one is like super awkward, right? And I don't like this. It looks like it's going to fall over. It's so top heavy. Look at all these leaves. I've been like knocking down leaves because I wasn't sure if me trying to grow a tree underneath existing leaves was causing them to be small. So I started cutting them down and I broke my shears, but I was cutting them down. That's why I have so many leaves here. And by the way, if you notice my level 7, it's because I spent a long time getting bones. I had some of these already, but I spent some more time getting bones. And I died because of creeper while I was doing that. So that's a thing. But I also got some wood. And I'm going to beef up this trunk a little bit so it doesn't look so awful. Do we need to... No, hold on. I'm trying to find a way to make it not too bulky, but at the same time, like, I don't want, like, right now, it's too thin right there, but if I just bring this down all the way, it might look too bulky, I think. Does that make sense? Well, make it make sense, because that's what I'm, it's my story, and I'm sticking to it. What if we did something like that? Like, how ugly is this tree now? I kind of want to bring this down and that down. Nope, I think I like that more the way it was. Yeah, that looks pretty good, I think. That looks a lot better. So all of these trees are going to get that treatment. This one right here, pull it down a little bit, one right there. Sure, we can have one on the little side right there. So how are you guys? I am all right, except I spilled on my keyboard. Yep, I spilled Coke on my keyboard, and now my backspace sticks really badly, and it kind of sucks. Gosh dang it. It's like, it's not a good backspace key anymore. It's a bad key. I could probably clean it, but I've tried taking this thing apart before, and that's not fun. I'm halfway considering just, since I'm considering getting a new computer soon, a rig, a proper rig, I almost just want to get a new keyboard and use it with this laptop until I get a new computer. Let's go and sleep. Okay, so that I was just walking by. That sticks out to me right there. That is one ugly side to the tree. So let's climb up there and beautify that a little bit. It's just, it's way too flat. It stops very abruptly. So let's bring this out. Like this, right? And it doesn't, and I like this right here. There's a hole right there. I like that. That kind of gives it something that there, that's hollow in there. It's not like all dense leaves in there. It's different densities in there that you can see. And now this is still pretty flat right here. So I'm going to try to find a few places that this can be brought out. Right there, there. Okay, so let's see how that looks. You want everything to look organic, but not Minecraft organic. Minecraft organic isn't very organic. Yeah, those are pretty cool. So this is just going to be kind of a... you know, untouched area right here. Let's do this pathway right here. And I'm trying to decide. I don't think I want to do this like dirt and gravel like all this. I was going to do that, but let's just make it different from the rest. Because I've been thinking about different roads, different levels of traffic, and using different roads, multiple different kinds of roads in the same build, and what kind of effect that can have on your builds. And I think that that is something that can really add something for you if you use it correctly. So this is a very, like, very unused path. It can really, I don't want that a path block. I will use that as a path block and that. No, that's too uniform. So let's make that and that not path blocks. That should be okay. So this is like used by one guy. This is his own path. So you could do this multiple ways probably. You could probably have it like opposite. Like this is a more used path, and the one with the gravel and the coarse dirt is your more used, but not like, not in my case, not my official like towny stone roads. But I feel like they could be flipped just fine and it would look real nice. So this right here, where we have come up to, is another area that I want to touch up. Yeah, so that looks pretty good right here. I feel like we could add another tree right here. Just something to note, I've been making these 5 blocks tall in case it's hard to count, and set that right next to it and then spam it with bone meal. If you do, sometimes this happens. I tried it with 6 and I'm not sure if it doesn't work, but it didn't work the time I tried it. I kind of want to know if you have to get rid of these leaves. I think since they're not full blocks, it's not going to affect the growth. So I'm going to put down another one and try. We don't have an unlimited. Yeah, see, it's not even growing. Now, forget the crappy tree, it's not even growing. So I'm going to wait for those to despawn. I'm on like my 4th or 5th try on that or something, and I'm waiting for them to despawn. In the meantime, though, I do want to mess around with some grass here. Yeah, just put some down. I don't really want any flowers, because it's just, how often do you see a tulip just in the wild? I mean, yeah, they do grow, but where I'm from, it's mostly grass out in the trees and stuff. So let's put some of that down. There are lots of flowers in this area, aren't there? So I've been playing NBA 2K. These grasses are almost too much. It's a lot for right next to a path. If I could have them like back here, more dense back there, then that'd be cool. But I've been playing 2K. NBA 2K. It came out on PC today as of this recording. And so some of you know I'm a big Wolves fan, Timberwolves. And one of the star players, or one of our future superstars or whatever, Andrew Wiggins, I was playing game 2 of the season, and I don't play the my player, my career stuff. It doesn't really appeal to me too much. I want to play as my team. Game 2, broke his ankle, out for 6 to 8 weeks. So I don't even, like, why? It was so sad and frustrating. Let me get these here, and we'll try this again. Please, 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 please. Come on. Hello? Sometimes it doesn't work at all. I think I have some more bone. Oh, look at that. Finally a good tree. This 5th or 6th try, or 4th or 5th, I'm not sure. But it did work, and let's take a look at all sides of it, make sure that it looks all right. This side is all right. I like it all. I like this side. So let's throw down some grass here, and then we're going to do some other things to kind of spruce up the this wilderness area here. I can use your bones. Thank you. Please. Got looting 2 on this sword. So gimme. I think I got 2 bones from that. Awesome. I think I've knocked down all the flowers. I see some twirling around, but I don't see any actually on the ground. Let's take it a step further. I mentioned how I'd like thicker grass, like it further back, right? That's a weird flower. Well, let's go with thicker grass further back. We can double up some of this stuff, huh? And just go around like that, especially back here, right? So yeah, I feel like if we did this, I feel like we could go quite a bit further with it, more than we have right now. Not sure what's going to go right here. We'll save that for there might be paths and stuff there for the Farmer's Guild, so I'm not going to go back further that way. But let's just do this. Let's put some tall ones right next to the tree. And get rid of that flower right next to the tree over here. Yeah. Kind of cover the base of it a little bit. Now that looks pretty good. Pretty good, but you know me. I like to put stuff between my paths and my stuff. So let's go ahead and do our stone walls that we like to do. Right here would probably be a good spot. No, let's try to keep it a little random. So like this. Do we have any brick? Don't have any brick. I do want walls. And that, I suppose. Let's put a wall right. Is that weird? That's weird. That's so weird. Let's get rid of that. Put that there. And what if we did this? Made it look like there's some stone on the ground to go with that. Kind of like that. And let's put one back there. And there. Let's make that one stone. Cool. And then I kind of like to give these walls two dimensions by putting leaves back here. Let's just do something like this. Get rid of that. Oh no, I don't want you. I do not want you. You are not wanted. Let's go right there. So that gives it a little bit of something. Let's do just a bush right here. We can do something like that. If we had fence, we could use that as sort of put that right there. I don't have any fence though. So let's do one of those deals. Another one right there. No, not that. Yeah, doesn't have to be perfect. So let's see what kind of feeling. This feels very, very boring to me. I just want to get a feeling of this whole pathway. This does not feel good to me. So let's do something like this. Right. Oh, my inventory. And get a wall in there. Get a couple of walls. And let's go ahead and make... Let's get rid of this sword. We don't need this sword right here. Let's make those path blocks. Maybe one of them a path block. Just to mix up that. So this feels much better right there. Let's do another deal right there. That separates this carrot. So you get what I'm doing here? I feel like I'm not really saying much, but these are the things that go through my head when I think of this. I'm walking through this and, you know, like right here, this obviously isn't good, right? Just plain grass blocks right here. Not gonna do it for me. I need some sort of wall right here. This is good right here. I feel like this has established a boundary between my pathway and these trees. This does that. This tall grass does that. There's more stuff that we can put back there probably, but this feels pretty good to me. Then we come over here, and I want to go grab something because I have another idea. I just want to touch this up a little bit. I noticed I'm pulling some inspiration from B-Dubs here in his video that I just put up when he did similar stuff. He put beaches, sand along a lot of the edges here. Let's do something like that. A lot of the edges, and it really added a lot, I think. I like the way that he put them everywhere. Let's leave some grass right there and right there. Right? Now, let's leave that one right there. That's fine. So look at all these colors that are down here when we come over here. I feel like we could put a regular tree right here. Or do we want to go all the way with it? Let's go all the way. That looks pretty good there, I think. I did have to touch it up a little bit. It was sort of an ugly tree. It's not as big as the others, but that's all right. So let's go and find something else to do. Put a tree right there and formed a bit of an archway here, which I actually think that I like. Remember when I added this fountain and then decided that I would leave it to see if it grew on me? Well, it never did. And now it's a big tree. And look at this. This was, that spawned all on its own. That branch, how cool is that? I've never seen a little branch reach out like that on a Minecraft generated structure. Maybe it looks a little narrow from this. I think it's fine. I like that a lot more than the way it was. Another thing that I wanted to do was get a proper walkway up to the Farmer's Guild. Just gonna follow this, the theme of this, and pull out that way. And there we go. A little bit of an entrance there. Feels a little bit more complete now. It is fair to say that there is not going to be another house right here. So we can fill this up with whatever the heck we want that we've been focusing on this episode. So I'm going to do a little bit of, I want to follow this theme just a little bit. And let's pull this out. Maybe you do it more than once. I don't want the whole way. What do I have underneath it? I have brick and stone. So let's do some of this action. I don't know if you know what I'm doing yet. I'm just making a little bit of a fence line, but not making it completely consistent along the whole thing. So there are going to be openings in it. So we can do something like that. We're not even going to have it. The wall itself's not even going to be completely perfect. So let's do one of these deals. Yeah. Let's actually put cobblestone down there. So that looks all right. That looks all right. Let's put something. It kind of looks like a pile of rocks. I was thinking about using that just out and about in the grass to look like a pile of rocks. I'm not sure if I'll do that. Let's get a tree in here. These trees are just too easy to make to not put everywhere. I forgot how easy they are. They add so much. Just they look like custom trees just because these big trees don't spawn naturally very often. And when you add in these custom trunks, then they really look pretty interesting and add a lot. You know what? We don't even need anything bigger than that, I don't think. Look at that. Yeah, that's fine. So now I'm just thinking. So when you walk up, and let's think of reveal and what you can see and what you can't see. So you walk up, and the gate right here is going to be the main thing that you see. You're going to see a flag peeking around in the back and the side of the building right there. There's stables over there, and before they were in full view, now they're behind a tree. What does that do for us? That, at first I was like, ooh, I don't know. But think about it. Add coarse dirt, gravel, something right there. I just need something to fit right there. The stable is not a main part of this build. It's not the most important thing. You could say that's the least important thing that we've put on here, other than like this wall, the archer's range. But as far as the actual building goes, this isn't important. This isn't, like, even from, like, a designer's point of view of whoever actually made this thing, theoretically, they're not like, ooh, I want to make these horse stables and everybody, I want that to catch everybody's eye. No, they'd probably want the rest of us to be eye-catching. So that puts this hidden, tucked away back there. And that makes one of those things, like we've talked about, that isn't the focal point but it leaves something for you to be found, for you to find. You can walk over here and you're like, oh, there's stables over here. You could walk by without even noticing them at all. But the fact that you do notice them lets you know that there's little hidden things tucked away. And that is one of my favorite things. And then you add in some bushes and some grass. And guess what? You have a completely new area than we did when I started working on this 10 minutes ago. Completely different feeling. And it's little stuff like this. I could spend 2-3 hours, come back here, and work on a wall or a building that would hardly be noticed. I mean, it's part of the building. It would be noticed, but it wouldn't feel like a huge improvement. I just made this little path right here. I just made a tree right here and threw down a wall and some grass. And it completely transformed how this area feels to me as someone who walks through it all the time. And that is a pretty magical thing. Does that work right there? That works right there. It's all right. So anyway, I think that's going to be it. There's going to be more of this kind of stuff that is going to have to be side work. I'm going to have to do it throughout the whole town, realistically. I mean, we do that as we go, but over here, it would be nice to make that entire thing covered in trees, kind of like that. Over here, we're putting more houses, but we don't really know where they're going all go yet, so that's going to have to wait. And we could probably fit a tree right here, maybe. We could put a tree out in the middle of the field and that would look pretty dang cool, I bet. We could put a tree right there and I bet that would add a lot, and that's just stuff that I'm gonna have to do. Look at that. Holy crap, I did not expect this. Just walking up here, this whole thing is completely, I feel like I need to maybe tweak this a little bit. That looks very blocky. Even for this game, that I get a completely different feeling because there's so many different layers of attention or things that you can give attention to. You see this tree right here. You see a bunch of houses hidden behind the trees. You see trees behind the houses. And then you keep walking back here, all the way back here. And guess what? There's like this gateway formed by the trees. And oh, there's stuff hidden behind the trees that are hidden behind the houses that are hidden behind the trees. That's really cool to me. This is the kind of stuff that really, you can be a builder. You can have some great stuff in your world, but if you don't pay attention to stuff like this, take 10, 15 minutes. Put some 5 tall pillars down, some saplings, bone meal them, and leave it. And it adds a ton of feeling to your world. You can have the most beautiful buildings, but if you don't have the environment to go with it, then I don't think that you're doing them any justice. So that's just something for y'all to think about. Thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed. That tree needs some touching up as well. Bye!